でなくて、本当に。
グリーンに、I guess it's evening.
Yeah, it's
evening. Good evening. It's wonderful to be here with you.
The point of view took us long.
We're expecting that God is going to bless us tonight.
Perciò quello mi ha dato poco, la questo Dio mi ha dato pace.
I'm actually excited, even in all this heat, that God is going to show up and do good things in our lives. But I think the first thing we need to be aware of is that the church, all in the Western world, is in a very difficult time. I understand that in this country, probably 10% of the Catholics are going to Mass on Sunday. And out of that 10%, probably 8% of them are women and 2% men.
In the 10% e 8% genski, 2% stamoci.
And there needs to be a real change in all of that. I ran several businesses before I preached the gospel. And if I lost 90% of my customers in my business, I would have had to put most of my workers out of work. See, we're all workers of the kingdom of God. And I don't want you to lose your jobs.
And
I want to keep my job too. So what we all need to be praying for and working at is the new evangelization that the Pope has called for.
Je to, da si želimo novo evangelizacijo, za katero nas je poklical papež.
Francis is not the first pope to call for this. It started with John Paul and it's continued.
Torej, papež Frančišek je prvi papež, ki nas k temu kliče, že, kako znate?
John Paul.
Jan Paul II je začel že s tem izrazom klicati.
See, unfortunately, most people think if they just baptize the Catholic, they get a free pass to go to heaven.
Torej, večina katoličanov misli, da če so krščani, da imajo že vstopnico za nebesa.
And that's not what God has revealed to us about the truth.
Ampak to pa ni tisto, kar Bog razodeva o teh resnicah.
We hear also that God loves everyone. You know, everyone will go to heaven. Don't worry about it.
Torej, mi razmišljamo tako. Bog ljubi vse. Torej, vsi bodo šli v nebesa.
And that's not true at all.
Ampak to sploh ni res.
God loves everyone, yes.
Resnica je, da Bog ljubi vsako.
But if you don't obey his laws, if you don't obey his commandments,
ampak če ne poslušaš njegovih zapovedi in zakonov, potem
you're going to go to hell for all eternity.
Boš šel v pekel za vso večnost.
See, today we don't really believe there is a hell.
Danes ljudje nasplošno sploh ne verjamejo, da pekel obstaja.
You know, there's no real devil, there's no real hell, it's just bad days.
Se pravi, ne obstaja pravi hudič, pravi pekel, ampak samo slabi dnevi so.
But there is a hell.
V resnici pa pekel obstaja.
And it's a very serious thing that we need to think about.
In je to ena stvar, o kateri moramo resno razmišljati.
Many of our children may go there if we don't change things in the church today.
Torej, mnogi naši otroci ne bodo prišli v pekel, da bi znal to.
They will go if we don't change.
Se pravi, mnogi naši otroci bodo šli v pekel, če mi ne bomo nekaj naredili.
We have no support anymore for the younger generation.
We
don't have good support for the younger generation.
Se pravi, nimamo dobre podpore za mlade, generacije.
And we've made excuses for allowing all of this bad things to happen in the church.
Imamo polno izgovorov za vse slabe stvari, ki se dogajajo v cerkvi.
But Saint Faustina wrote in her diary.
Sfânta Faustina a zapisat la dnevnic său.
I noticed one thing when I visited hell.
Eno stvar că se mă obiscala pekel.
Most of the souls that were in hell.
Vecina duși sol de pătru.
Were people who disbelieved there was a hell.
Sunt tisti ki nisu verjeli da pekel obstaja.
See, we need to know that this is serious times and it's all about salvation.
Torej, vedeti moramo, da so to pomembni časi, resni časi in da vsi potrebujemo odrešenje.
Next year is going to be a special year of mercy for the church.
Naslednje leto bo posebno leto, proglasil papež, leto Božjega usmiljenja.
And mercy is being offered to us now.
In Božje usmiljenje se nam zdaj ponuja.
But we have to receive that mercy.
Ampak to Božje usmiljenje moramo sprejeti.
That's why the new evangelization is so important.
Zato je nova evangelizacija tako pomembna.
Today too many people think everyone is going to be saved.
Preveč ljudi danes misli, vsi bodo rešeni.
And we need to tell them the truth.
Mi pa jim moramo povedati resnico.
The Bible tells us that the road to hell is wide and easily traveled.
Ker Sveto pismo pravi, široka je cesta in se lahko po njej hodi, ni problema po njej hodi.
And the road to heaven is narrow and difficult and few take
it. Ta široka cesta pelje v pekel, potem ko je ozka pot in težka pot, ki pa pelje v nebesa.
So that's the first thing that we need to let people know about the new evangelization. There is a heaven, there is a hell.
Torej, prva stvar, ki moramo o tem povedati v novi evangelizaciji, je to, da obstaja nebesa, ampak obstaja tudi pekel.
And the second thing blocking the new evangelization is the new Pentecost meeting.
In druga stvar, ki jo potrebujemo, je so nove dinkoške, krst v Svetem Duhu.
We need to learn from the very first evangelization.
Učiti se moramo iz prvih časov evangelizacije.
There were certain secrets of how to evangelize in the very with the apostles.
Se pravi, določene skrivnosti so kako evangelizirati, kako so to počeli apostoli.
And the last four popes had prayed that we would have a new Pentecost.
In zadnje štiri papeži so rekli, da bi imeli nove new Pentecost, nove vikošti.
In the second Vatican Council, St. John the 23rd said, we need to pray for new signs and wonders.
Se pravi, Janez 23. Papež je rekel, da prosimo, da bi Bog obnovil čudeže in čudesa.
And we need to pray for a new Pentecost.
In da moramo prositi za nove Pentecost.
We need that kind of power and that kind of joy that gives us the ability to evangelize.
Potrebujemo namreč novo moč kot neko veselje, da bi evangelizirali.
See, there was no group of people any better taught than the apostles.
Ni boljše skupine evangelizatorjev, kako so to apostoli.
They were very well prepared to go out and evangelize.
Bili so zelo dobro pripravljeni za iti ven in evangelizirati.
Their pastoral leader was Jesus Christ himself.
Njihov voditelj je bil Jezus Kristus.
Jesus taught them about the Bible.
Jezus jim je učil o Bibliji, o Svetem pismu.
He showed them how to carry out mission.
In kazal jim je, kako naj izvajajo te svoje misijonsko potovanje.
But before he returned to the Father, he said this.
Preden pa se je Jezus vrnil k svojemu očetu, je rekel to.
Wait in the city until the power from on high comes on you.
Počakajte v mestu, dokler moč najvišjega ne pride nad vas.
In a few days you will be baptized in the Spirit.
In v nekaj dneh boste krščeni v Svetem Duhu.
Now these men had already gone out and healed the sick, cast out demons, did lots of great work already.
Torej, učenci so v bistvu že hodili okrog in so oznanjali, in so ozdravljali bolne in izganjali demone.
But he said to them, don't go out on mission work until you're baptized in the Spirit.
Ampak Jezus jim je rekel, ne hodite na misijonsko potovanje, če niste prijeli Svetega Duha.
Now we talk about the baptism in the Holy Spirit.
Tukaj govorimo o krstu v Svetem Duhu.
We're talking about the renewal of our grace from baptism and confirmation.
Govorimo o obnovi krstne milosti in milosti, ki smo jo prijeli pri potrditvi Svetem Duhu, to je zakramentu birne.
See, after confirmation, our lives are supposed to look just like it looked in the Acts of the Apostles.
Se pravi, po birni bi jaz moral izgledati tako, bi to moral izgledati tako, kako je bilo pri apostolih, ko so prijeli Svetega Duha.
The apostles had so much power that Simon the magician wanted to buy this off Peter.
Se pravi, apostoli so imeli tako moč Svetega Duha, da je to en čarovnik Simon videl in je hotel to kupiti z denarjem, ta dar.
The magician saw it and he said, wow, these men really have power. I want this kind of power.
Torej, ta čarovnik Simon je videl to moč in je rekel, jaz si želim tako moč.
Because Peter told him, you can't buy it. You have to receive it from the Holy Spirit.
Sveti Peter mu je rekel, ne moreš to kupiti z denarjem, to moraš prijeti od Svetega Duha.
Do any of us have magicians running around behind us saying, where did you get your power from?
Ali za katerim od vas hodi kakšen čarovnik in sprašuje, kje si dobil to moč, ki imaš ti?
We don't. Why don't we?
Nič. Zakaj? Zakaj ne?
We don't expect to have all that God has for us.
Ker ne pričakujemo, da bi mi imeli to, kar je Bog že pripravil, kar Bog ima za nas.
Why should people come to church if their lives never change?
Zakaj bi ljudje hodili v cirkev, če se njihovo življenje nikoli ne spremeni?
Why do they come to church? Because their father came to church?
Kaj ne bi hodili v cirkev zato, ker je njihov oče hodil v cirkev?
We're supposed to experience something in our bodies, in our lives, when we come to Christ.
Mi bi morali iskusiti nekaj v našem življenju, v našem telesu, kada pridemo k Jezusu.
Today in the United States, when the young people receive confirmation,
danes, kada v Združenih državah Amerike mladi prejmejo birmo, sakrament birme,
it's like graduation from school, they leave the church.
Tako da bi dobili diplomo, da lahko odidemo, kako bi šole, kako da bi diplomo greš, greš več na...
There's something wrong.
Nekaj je wrong.
When they're not experiencing, they're not seeing the power of the Holy Spirit.
Nimajo iskustva, niso iskusili moč, moči Svetega Duha.
So what happened in the Bible?
Torej, kaj se je zgodilo v Svetem pismu?
They stayed in the city.
Ostali so v mestu.
They prayed.
Molili se.
And the Holy Spirit fell on them.
Sveti Duh je padel na njih.
They rushed out into the streets.
Stekli so na ulice.
And they proclaimed the wonderful works and deeds of the Lord.
In oznanjali so velika Božja dela.
Peter gets up and says, this is the promises of the Holy Spirit.
Sveti Peter je vstal in je rekel, to je obljuba Svetega Duha.
And it's not just for us, it's for everyone.
In to ni samo za nas, to je za vsakega.
So the very first sermon from the very first pope was about the baptism of the Spirit.
Torej, prva pridiga prvega papeža je bila o Svetem Duhu, krstu Svetem Duhu.
And he said, all the gifts of the Spirit are for everyone.
Vsi darovi Svetega Duha so za vse ljudi.
Are we using the gifts of the Holy Spirit?
Ali mi uporabljamo darove Svetega Duha?
When's the last time you cast out a demon?
Kdaj ste nazadnje izganjali kakšnega demona?
Are they Catholic?
Ali ste vi katoličani?
Catholics are supposed to cast out demons.
Katoliki naj bi izganjali demone.
Heal the sick.
Ozdravljali bolne.
And preach the good news.
In oznanjali dobro novico.
It's easy to be a Catholic.
To je lahko biti katolik, ne?
You just do three things.
Samo tri stvari moraš delati.
Can you do three things for God?
Lahko naredite vi tri stvari za Boga?
But we need to believe we can do them.
Ampak moramo verjeti, da lahko to storimo.
We need to be working at our faith so that we do these things. We need to work at our faith.
Se pravi, delovati moramo iz vire.
If everyone here cast out a demon next week,
če bi nekdo tukaj izganjal demona naslednji teden,
the week after next, this church would be full with young people.
Če bi ga uspešno izgnal, bi tukaj bila potem naslednji teden polna cerkva.
Would you want to see a powerful church?
A ne bi radi videli polno cerkev, polno ljudi?
Does anyone want power in the church?
Kdo želi moč v cerkvi, da bi bila moč Svetega Duha v cerkvi? Dobro. Dve roke.
All right. Go do it.
Pojdite in to delajte.
It's not for the priest. It's for everyone.
Nu samo za duhovnike. To je
za Peter said all the gifts are for everyone, not just for the apostles.
Če vidimo predivo prvega papeža Petra, vidimo da pravi da dar svetega duha za vse ljudi.
We want to receive them and we want to give them away freely.
Želimo ga prijeti in ga zaston dati naprej.
And people can receive them in the Alpha course or Life in the Spirit seminar.
Torej, ljudje ta dar lahko prejmejo na tečaju Alfa, na seminarju za izvitje svetega duha.
You can just go home and pray for them and they'll come to you.
Greste pa domov, se zabrete sobo in kličete pri sveti duh. Sveti duh bo prišel pri vas.
We all have a mission.
Torej, vsi mi imamo poslanstvo.
To help things come alive in people's lives.
Da pomagamo, da določene stvari oživijo v ljudeh, v njihovih življenjih.
What we learned from the first evangelization is,
kaj smo se naučili iz prvega oznanjevanja apostolov?
We can't have people witnessing to the ends of the earth unless they're baptized in the Spirit.
Ne moramo pričakovati, da bodo ljudje pričevali do konca sveta, če nimajo izkustva krsta v Svetem Duhu.
Or they renew their sacramental life.
In da na ta način obnovijo svoje zakramentalno življenje.
There are no set rules for evangelization.
Ni nekih napisanih pravil, kako naj bi evangelizirali.
We have to hear God and do what He's called us to do.
Poslušati moramo Boga in storiti to, kar nam reče.
One rule I like to make up.
Eno pravilo, ki ga imam jaz rad.
This may not be God, but I like it this way.
Mogoče ne bi Boga, ampak jaz ga imam rad.
That everyone this year has to evangelize someone of the opposite sex.
Da bi vsak v tem letu evangeliziral eno osebo nasprotnega spola.
The next year we have as many men as women in this church.
In naslednje leto bi imeli več moških kot ženskih tukaj v cerkvi.
And the men could bring them a few, the five women with them.
In potem bi možet nesli še pet žena vsak.
We are desperate to change the face of our church.
Obupno si želimo, da bi spremenili obličje naše cerkve.
Is this going to be the last generation of Catholics in Slovenia?
Ali bo to zadnja generacija katolikov v Sloveniji?
When Saint Paul wanted to go to Asia and evangelize in Asia,
ko je sveti Pavel šel v Azijo in je tam evangeliziral,
it says the Holy Spirit stopped him from going.
Je rekel, da ga je Sveti Duh ustavil, da ne bi šel tam.
In just two chapters later it says he was led to Asia by the Holy Spirit to evangelize.
Čez dve poglavje pa beremo, da ga je Sveti Duh vodil v Azijo.
And he said that when he was led by the Spirit, everyone that listened to him believed.
In potem piše, da ko je bil voden od Svetega Duha, vsi, ki so ga poslušali, so sprejeli vero.
So I would have loved to evangelize everyone, but I can only evangelize the people God sends me to.
Torej, ne morem biti voljni kar evangelizirati vsakomu, ampak tistim ljudem, ki mi jih Bog pošlje.
You know, we all want to evangelize our families.
Vsi mi bi želeli evangelizirati naše domače.
But many times our families won't listen to us.
A mnogo krat se zgodi, da naši domači nočejo poslušati nas.
So we need to pray to God to send someone else to evangelize our family members.
Torej moramo moliti Bogu, da Bog pošlje druge osebe, ki bodo evangelizirale naše sorodnike, naše najbližje.
Then we can go evangelize their family members.
In potem bomo šli mi in bomo evangelizirali njihove domače.
But Christianity first and foremost is about the relationship with Jesus Christ.
Torej, zakaj gre pri krščanstvu? Predvsem za prijateljski odnos z Jezusom.
It's not about becoming a theologian and learning a lot of things.
Ni zato, da bi študirali teologijo in marsikaj se poglavljali.
It's the difference between knowing about love and actually falling in love.
To je v bistvu razlika, kot če bi, ali vem, kaj je to biti zaljubljen, ali pa, da sem dejansko
You can have a degree in theology and not know Jesus at all.
Lahko imaš doktorat iz teologije, pa v bistvu ne poznaš osebno
Jezusa. In John 15 it says it this way.
Janez 15 poglavje pa pravi takole.
Whoever loves me will keep my word.
Kdorkoli me ljubi, bo držal. držal moju besedu.
And my father will love him.
I moj oče ga bo ljubil.
And we will come to him and make our dwelling in him.
In prišli bomo k njemu in bomo prebivali pri njemu.
If we can fall in love with Jesus.
Če mi se zaljubimo v Jezusa.
People around us will see that we love God.
Ljudje okrog nas bodo videli, da ljubimo Boga.
And they'll come and ask you about your relationship with God.
In bodo začeli spraševati o vašem odnosu z Bogom.
God wants to evangelize more than we want to evangelize.
Bog želi evangelizirati bolj, kakor se mi želimo evangelizirati.
So our first job is to fall deeply in love with God.
Torej, naša prva naloga je, da se globoko zaljubimo v Boga.
And be led by the Holy Spirit to bring others to know Him.
In pustimo, da nas Sveti Duh vodi, da ga še vlogi spoznamo.
Every month there's petitions written by the Pope for different regions. Every year.
Petitions.
Yeah, they're little petitions, you know, we should pray for the circle.
Every month. Vsak mesec so pač papež napiše neke prošnje, za katere se namenjene, da se po svetu molilo.
A few months ago, this was the Pope's petition.
Torej, pred par meseci nazaj, da pa taka prošnja.
He says, to help all Christians realize that we are not only receivers, but proclaimers of the word.
Da bi pomagalo kristjanom spoznati, da nismo samo sprejemniki, ampak tudi tisti, ki oznanjamo Božje delo, Božjo besedo.
The Pope was saying, we need to understand, it's good that we know the Lord, but we need to tell other people about God.
Dobro je, da poznamo Boga, ampak moramo tudi povedati drugim o Bogu.
And we need to evangelize everywhere we are, in our workplace, in our homes, everywhere.
In potrebno je, da evangeliziramo posod, tam kjer smo, v službi, doma.
It's more difficult sometimes in the workplace too, to be able to talk about God.
Težko je tudi na delovnem mestu govoriti o Bogu.
Most of them worry about, am I able to answer all the questions that people would ask me.
Potem se mi včasih sprašujemo, ali bomo lahko odgovorili na vsa vprašanja, ki nam jih bodo zastavili ljudje.
Today most people know almost nothing about God in heaven or anything.
Velika večina ljudi danes sploh nič ne ve o nebesih, o Bogu.
If you're coming to church at all, you know more than most people in this country.
Če vi hodite v cerkve, potem pomeni, da veste več o Bogu, kako bi marsikdo v tej državi.
So don't be afraid to talk about God to people in work.
Torej, ne bojte se govoriti o Bogu ljudem na delovnem mestu.
And you want to be aware that there are some people already looking to find out about God.
In morate vedeti, da zunaj cerkve so ljudje, ki dejansko iščejo Boga.
These people are prepared to hear about God.
Oni so že pripravljeni, da bi nekaj slišali o Bogu.
The Bible says, unless the Lord builds the house, we labor in vain.
Sveto pismo piše, če Gospod ne zida hiše, se zaman trudijo zidarji.
So God has already prepared the hearts of many people that you might be working with today.
Torej, Bog že je pripravil srca ljudi, s katerimi se lahko mi srečamo in jih potem evangeliziramo.
But we also need to know that we need to live holy, godly lives in front of the people we work with.
Res pa je, da moramo tudi mi živeti sveto Božje življenje pred temi predočmi teh ljudi.
Because the people in work are watching you.
Ker ljudje, s katerimi delamo v modernih mestih, gledajo na nas.
And they want to hear about God. If we just let them know, yeah, I know about God and I'd like to talk about it.
Želijo slišati o Bogu, če ne damo vedeti, da tudi mi radi govorimo o Bogu.
See, Jesus sent the apostles out just to evangelize Jews, not the regular other people.
Torej, Jezus je nekako poslal apostole, da znanjajo Judom, ne drugim narodom.
Because he saw that the fields were white for harvest, it says in the Bible.
Ker pravi Jezus, da je videl, da je polje pripravljeno za zrelo za žetve.
If we ask God to open our eyes, we'll see that there are people around us that really want to hear about God.
Torej, če bomo odprli oči, bomo videli, da so ljudje, ki bi želeli slišati nekaj o Bogu.
Whenever St. Paul went to a new city, he would go to the synagogue and find the people that were looking and for more of God.
Святий Павел ходив із міста в місто, він прийшов і йшов в синагогу, і там поїхав люди, які ради не кисліше до Богу.
They're the easiest converts.
Easy?
They're easier to convert, to bring to Jesus, mm-hmm. someone that's looking.
Некого, який є тако живе, який живе до Богу, є лажі потім говорити, тоді він лажі буде сприємно.
St. Paul says this in the Bible.
Святий Павел правив Святий Письмо такого.
Conduct yourselves wisely toward outsiders.
Modro se približajte znanjem.
Making the most of every opportunity.
Making the most. Da iskoristite maksimalno svaku priložnost.
Let your speech always be gracious.
Nebo vaš govor razmiraj tako mir.
So that you may know how you ought to answer every question.
Da biste vedeli kako odgovarjati na svako vprašanje.
So we want to be good people around the people we work with or anywhere.
Želimo biti dobri ljudje tam, kjer delamo.
And we want to be prepared to answer questions.
In želimo biti pripravljeni da odgovarjamo na vprašanje.
We don't need a degree in theology.
Ne potrebujemo neke diplome iz teologije.
But you should be familiar with the Bible, familiar with the teachings of the church.
Проповеда смо сезнанени за науком церкви и за Святим Писмом.
And we're trying to evangelize and care for the whole person, not just their souls. We care about everything.
Želimo vse ljudi evangelizirati.
So we want to be people that are above reproach, living honest, truthful lives.
We are people
above reproach. We want to be honest and truthful in our lives.
Želimo biti iskreni in resnicoljubni v našem življenju.
And if we're in a work, we want to be the best workers in our job.
Torej, želimo biti najboljši delavci na svojem delovnem mestu.
We want to serve our human employers like we're serving God.
Da bi služili našim delodajalcem, kakor služimo Bogu.
So, we want to be pleasant and open to receive and give word from the Lord.
Torej, želimo biti pripravljeni dati darove.
Not judgmental or condemning the people also.
Spravi, ne želimo sojati ljudi, ali soditi ljudi in jih obsojati.
If we are thinking about the fact every day that we're on earth to help somebody else know Jesus, if we think about it every day,
yes.
That we're evangelists.
Če mislimo, da smo, če vsak dan mislimo, da smo mi v bistvu neke vrste evangelizatori,
our minds and our hearts will be prepared to speak about Jesus in the right way.
Bo naše možgani, naše srce bo pripravljeno, da bomo spregovorili o Bogu.
And we need to know that people want to know about God.
Moramo vedeti, da ljudje si želijo nekaj vedeti o Bogu.
And that God will use us to evangelize people.
In Bog nas bo uporabil, da bomo mi evangelizirali ljudi.
Now in the world today there are over a billion Catholics.
Na svetu je več kot milijarda katolikov.
There are only 7 billion people in the world.
Približno 7 milijard vseh ljudi.
So if every Catholic evangelized one person in a year,
če bi vsak katolik evangeliziral samo eno osebo na leto,
next year we have 2 billion.
Naslednje leto je 2 milijarde katolikov.
The next year we have 4 billion.
In še naslednje leto imamo že 4 milijarde katolikov.
And the next year everybody in the world would be a Catholic.
In tretje leto že
everyone in the world.
Si, yes. Si bi bliže katoliko, tretje leto, tri leto evangelizacije.
So all you need to evangelize is 4 people.
Samo 4 ljudi morate evangelizirati, vsak od nas.
In the next 4 years.
V naslednjih 4 letih.
And everybody will be Catholic in the whole world.
In cel svet bo katolički.
It's not such a big task.
Ni težka naloga.
Ladies, I want you to evangelize a man, not the first one.
Torej, žene morate najprej evangelizirati svojega moža.
And then next year you can go back to evangelizing women.
In potem naslednje leto greste lahko evangelizirate ženske.
Because we'll have an even group.
Tako da bi radi bi imeli pol pol, ne, pol muških, pol ženskih cirkvi. Svak dan ko se zbudiš, prosiš Boga, daj mi dar evangelizacije.
And asking God to give you all the gifts of the Holy Spirit.
I prosiš Boga da ti da sve darove Svetoga Duha.
Which is wisdom and knowledge.
Mudrost, vednost.
And you can have prophetic gifts to tell to people.
Tudi dar prerokovanja, takve poveš ljudi.
When you give a word of knowledge to someone, you can evangelize them very easily.
Če imaš dar vednosti, lahko zelo enostavno način evangeliziraš.
So be prepared.
Bodi pripravljen.
Be in love with God.
Bodi v Božji ljubezni.
And then be brave enough to do what God's called you to do.
Bodi korajžen dovolj, da storiš to, kar Bog želi od tebe, da storiš.
Can we stand?
Stanemo.
Father God,
Oče Bog,
I ask you to encourage us today.
Prosim te da nas opogumiš danas.
That we will be proclaimers of your word.
Da bomo oznanjivalci tvoje besede.
We know that the church may be in trouble.
Vemo da je crkva v težavah.
But we know you're not in trouble.
Vemo pa da ti nisi v težavah.
That you're not fearful at all.
Ti sploh nisi v strahu, ti se ne bojiš.
And that you have chosen all of us to do your works.
In izbral si vsakega izmed nas. Send
your Spirit on us right now.
Pošli svojega svetega Duha na nas zdaj.
Encourage us, strengthen us.
Spodbudi nas, ukrepi nas.
Give us a vision for evangelizing the entire world back to you, Lord Jesus.
Daj nam vizijo kako evangelizirati celi svet.
I ask that all in Jesus' name.
Sve to prosim v Jezusovem imenu.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You can be seated.
Lahko se vedno.
Now I'd like to be able to pray with anyone that has any needs at all.
Sedaj bi rad molil za vsakega izmed vas, ki ima kakršnokoli potrebe.
Whether it's physical healing, gifts of the Spirit, whatever you might need.
Telesno zdravljenje, darove Svetega Duha, kakorkoli želite.
God wants to show miracles here today.
Danes želi Bog tukaj pokazati čudeže.
Because if 100 people walk out of here and talk about miracles, tomorrow more people will want to know.
Ker če te 100 ljudi pride v nas cirkev in začne govoriti o čudežih, bo naslednji teden te polno ljudi prišlo.
I can believe all I want that you're going to have miracles. But you need to believe with me.
Torej, jaz lahko verjamem, da boste prišli čudež, ampak vi morate verovati z mano.
Even Jesus couldn't work miracles in his own hometown because they didn't believe.
Tudi Jezus v svojem rodnem kraju ni mogel delati čudežev, ker ljudje niso verjeli.
So if anyone wants a miracle in their life tonight,
če kdo želi čudež v svojem življenju ta večer,
I want you to come forward and receive a miracle.
Želim, da pridete naprej in sprejmete ta čudež.
I'm going to just ask people to come up. Don't know. Most people just stay in your seats. Let the people in the front row or if somebody needs to leave early, you come up first.
Tisti,
so you won't be standing in the aisle for a whole hour.
Tisti, ki se modi naj prvi pridejo, če imajo za odit, ker ni treba, da kar vsi greste v vrsto, da ne boste celo uro stali, pa sproti prihajate. Ne?
So if anyone needs to leave early, please, you come up first. If not, the people in the first few rows just come up and pray with you.
Če se komu modi, ne pride prvi naprej, ostali pa kasneje. Pomoliti za vsake.
Zdravljeni bolezni. In poslanih je znanje Božje kraljestvo, zdravlja bolnike ter jim rekel: nič ne jemljite na pot, ne palice, ne torbe, ne kruha in ne denarja. In katerokoli hišo pridete, tam ostanite in od tam odhajate. In kjerkoli vas ne sprejmejo, pojdite iz tistega mesta in odnesite prah svojih nog v pričevanje za prnje. Šli so in hodili od vasi do vasi, oznanili blagovest in posod ozdravljeni. Poslušali smo Kristusa.
Exorcism is for the priest that's appointed by the bishop.
se pravi eksorcizem je rezerviran za duhovnika, ki ga pooblasti škof.
And the church teaches us that only the bishop and his appointed priest can read the exorcist prayer.
In cerkev nas uči, da samo duhovnik, ki ga pooblasti škof, lahko izmoli tisto molitev, ki se imenuje eksorcizem.
But every Christian has the ability to cast out a demon.
Ampak vsak kristijan ima pa sposobnost izganjati demone.
Because demons are harassing us all the time.
Demoni nas napadajo vse čas.
It's very rare that you're possessed by a demon.
Zelo redko se zgodi, da bi nekdo bil poseden od hudega duha.
But most of us are harassed almost every day by a demon.
Ampak oblegajo pa nas skoraj vsak dan, ne? Praktično vsak dan nas oblegajo.
And we as brothers and sisters in Christ,
torej mi smo brati in sestre v Kristusu,
we can lay hands on each other.
Lahko položimo roko drug na drugega.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I command those spirits to leave.
In rečemo, v imenu Jezusa Kristusa ukazujem hudim duhovom, da odidejo.
It's the power of the name of Jesus that casts out demons, not you.
Torej moč, ki je v Jezusovem imenu izganja demone, ne ti.
And God wants us all to know we're supposed to use that.
In Bog želi, da bi mi to moč uporabljali.
Every time I pray with someone and they go through deliverance,
vsakeč, ko molim za nekoga, kdo gre skozi osvobajanje,
they become much more committed to Christ.
Postane ta oseba bolj predana Jezusu.
People that don't know much about God at all want to know much once they're free from those demons.
Osebe, ki ne vejo nič o Bogu, želijo vedeti več, kadar so osvobojeni od demonov.
When someone's healed of cancer, when someone gets out of a wheelchair because we pray, they're converted too.
Kadar nekdo ozdravi od raka in ostane iz vozička, se spreobrne.
God wants to show power.
Bog želi pokazati moč.
The Holy Spirit came to release that power in all of us.
Sveti Duh je prišel, da bi osvobodil to moč vsakem izmed nas.
We all receive the power in baptism.
Vsi smo prijeli to moč v pri krstu.
It was more released in our confirmation.
Bila je še bolj sproščena pri biru.
But it's only through faith in God's word that we can exercise those gifts.
A le v viri v Božjo besedo lahko izvajamo moč teh darov.
So we need to believe that God's word says we can do these things.
Moramo verjeti, da je Božja, da mi lahko delamo te stvari.
Then have the courage to do what God has told us.
In potem moramo imeti tudi koraž, da to naredimo, kar nam Bog govori, da delamo.
The church is in a crisis.
Cerkev je v krizi.
And the answer to the crisis is,
in odgovor na krizo je,
every one of us evangelize people through the power of the Spirit.
Da vsak od nas evangelizira druge ljudi v moči Svetega Duha.
Amen.
Amen.